WCFL continues with Jim Stagg and British Countdown. Small Faces on British Countdown. It's called Hey Girl. They had a number one song in England their first time out, and I got a feeling this one's going to repeat for them. We got two for you.
Originally yours.
WCFL.
WCFL Twin Spin.
John Lennon. Very long they were making their way over to Tokyo for a big concert appearance, and then on to Germany, and then, of course, they're going to be coming to this country around August the 12th, and they'll open up that concert series right here in Chicago, too, and it's going to be nice to see those guys after such a long, long time. Last year on the American Beatle Tour, I picked up some Beatle souvenirs, and I told you, between now and the time they arrive in this country, we're going to be calling out some Stagg Line membership club card numbers and awarding those Beatle souvenirs. Tonight, we've got a winner for you. If your club card number happens to be 6718, then you're the winner for this evening. Just send that club card in to me, and I'll return it with your Beatle souvenir. Address it to Stagg Line membership club cards and care British Countdown, WCFL Radio, Chicago 10. Now, if you don't have one of the club cards, make sure you get one, because you could be the winner of one of those Beatles souvenirs. Send me a self-addressed stamped envelope, and once again, the address. It's Stagg Line Membership Club Cards in care of WCFL Radio, Chicago 10, Illinois.
You are listening to WCFL.
We got a great British battle for you this evening on British Countdown. Not too long ago, I told you that Keith Reff, the lead singer of the Yardbirds, was going to be going solo in one of his songs, and we have that particular song for you this evening, and we've also got the guy who wrote the tune and his interpretation of those lyrics. Tonight on our British battle, we're going to have the song Mr. Zero, first sung by Keith Reff, and then sung by the guy who wrote it, Bob Lynn. Now, we want you to decide who does the best job on this song. Remember, after you decide, all you got to do is put Keith Reff or Bob Lynn on the back of a postcard and address that postcard vote to British Battle in care of WCFL Radio, Chicago 10, Illinois. Here we go. Candidate number one, this is Keith Reff.
Diamonds of silvery rain in the
fountains and 10-cent red roses from department store counters. Watching the moonlight reflect off the river, beside where the trains cross the bridge and slow down. Trains with white letters on black iron sides, and wild rushing water that all rolls away. And little miss someone does not want to stay. Everyone's moving with places to go, and Mr. Zero, he sadly stands still. As the water goes one way, the train goes another. Mr. Zero stands still and miss someone don't bother. Yesterday's kiss will be cold by tomorrow, as campfires of midnight dissolve in the darkness. The room is deserted, the blinds have been drawn. Little miss someone has packed up and gone. Fast-moving cars disappear down the highway with signs that say hitchhikers do not disturb. Mr. Zero looks quietly up from the curb. Morning has faded and shadows have grown, and little miss someone is on her way home. Mr. Zero stands watching her plane flies above, and with frostbitten hands waves goodbye to his love.
Oh, yesterday's kiss will be cold by tomorrow, as campfires of midnight dissolve in the darkness. The room is deserted, the blinds have been drawn. Little miss someone has packed up and gone. Fast-moving cars disappear down the highway with signs that say hitchhikers do not disturb. Mr. Zero looks quietly up from the curb. Morning has faded and shadows have grown. Little miss someone is on her way home. Mr. Zero stands watching her plane flies above, and with frostbitten hands waves goodbye to his love.
That's our two candidates for this evening. First of all, Keith Ralph and Bob Lynn. Remember now, we want your postcard vote. You put the guy you want to vote on the back of a postcard and address that to British Battle in care of WCFL Radio, Chicago 10. Next week, we're going to be drawing out five of those postcards and awarding to you the song called The Pied Piper. We're 11 minutes away from the hour. WCFL, it's time for...
England swings like a pendulum do. Bobby's own bicycles, two by two. Westminster Abbey, the Tower of Big Ben, the rosy red cheek.
Now, standing by to report exclusively for you on WCFL's British Countdown, here's our exclusive London hotline correspondent, the Beatles press officer, Tony Verrill.
The Beatles, the Rolling Stones, and Bob Dylan got together several times during Dylan's first week in the UK. In fact, Dylan met up with Paul McCartney, Keith Richard, and Brian Jones less than 12 hours after he flew into London. By coincidence, all four boys happened to choose to spend that one particular evening at Dolly's discotheque. At around 1 in the morning, they left Dolly's and went back to Bob's suite at the Mayfair Hotel. There, Paul played some of the special tracks from the Beatles' next album. Not to be outdone, Dylan produced copies of tracks he'd just made for his next album before the beginning of the tour. Later, and before Dylan left for Dublin, the rest of the Beatles spent most of one complete night chatting with him and discussing transatlantic recording trends. A year or two ago, a group which came from Liverpool had a pretty good head start in life. London recording managers were more than ready to listen to just about anything remotely musical which originated in Beatle territory. Today it's a different story. In fact, more than a few of Liverpool's groups are having less and less success in the national charts this year. One of those less fortunate outfits was the Merseybeats. Eventually, the foursome split up, leaving Tony Crane and Bill Kingsley as a singing duo which has become now the Merseys. This month, Tony and Bill, the Merseys, are back in Britain's top 20 with a chart smasher entitled Sorrow. And I think it's going to climb higher still before the powerful record reaches its popularity peak. And now on Hotline London, it's time for this week's news briefs. The Dave Clark Five will guest in the London-made TV spectacular Lucy Looks at London, co-starring Lucia Ball and Anthony Newley. Further, summertime concert tour of the US lined up for the Hollies. They'll be on your side of the Atlantic for 6 weeks from the end of July. Cilla Black, just back from sun-soaking Portugal vacation to promote her June record release, Don't Answer Me. The Mindbenders to play college and fair dates in America all through July. Norma Tanaga and Gene Pitney due in London during June. Loving Spoonful will be back with us for 2 weeks in August, and we're hoping to see the Mamas and the Papas in the later half of September. Danish newspaper tampered with a picture of Ringo's baby Zach, gave the infant a superimposed beetle mop complete with long sideburns. New UK single by Barbara Streisand is called Sam You Made the Pants Too Long. They say the Trogs will be the biggest UK success of 1966 group-wise, and I'm inclined to believe it. Every pop trade paper in London carried a hard-hitting attack on the Mindbenders by the group's former singing star Wayne Fontana, who is now currently enjoying solo success via the single Come On Home. Just about half of our record critics are disgusted with Capitol for releasing Downtown by Mrs. Miller. The other half fall about with laughter at the very mention of the lady's name. I'm in the second lot. And that's about all for this week from the UK pop scene. This has been Hotline London for WCFL Chicago, Tony Barrow, reporting.
Tony's back with us next week, of course. Right now we go with the sound of number 13 in England. These are the Mersey here, and it's called Sorrow.
With your long blonde hair and your eyes of blue, the only thing I ever get from you.
Song in England. Those are the Mersey, and it's called Sorrow. We got a twin spin. Here's that brand new one by the DC5.
I don't know what she will do.
by. In quick review for you, British Capsule Countdown. England's top 10 on Chicago 10.
You make my heart sing.
9.
The touch the sound of silence.
8.
What's it all about? I'll be.
7.
That's count of 3. Gotta stay close by me.
6.
Bang, bang.
By and holding for England's number one song.
And number one for the second week running, top of the pops in Britain, Pretty Flamingo by the Manfred Mann Group.
If she just would.
The number one song in England, Manfred Mann and his group, and it's called Pretty Flamingo. The word is that that song is going to be covered by a couple of American artists, but that's the original version, and it should be out here in this country before very long, too. That's going to do it to it for British Countdown this evening. Thank you so very much for joining us. Of course, next week, Tony Barrow is going to be back for Talk Time, and he'll be talking to George Martin, the Beatles' recording manager, about that brand new album they're still making. And I'll be back here covering that pop music scene from A to Z. Music is my business. I hope my business is your pleasure. Good night, everybody.
British Countdown, another Chicago first from WCFL.